A lot of people first got turned on to the band from the song Glycerin. I don't know if it's lyrical content, or is it vocal delivery, or if it's just the sparseness of the song, but a lot of people fall for that song. When did it hit you the same way that it might have hit a listener? Did it affect you the same way?
Yeah. I always find that the best songs, or not necessarily the best songs, but certain songs work really well when you write them quickly, and that was sort of 10-15 minutes. I just one day had it was really quick, because you might wait a few years to get to that point, of course, but when it actually comes out, yeah, it was good. I was really happy with it. I just knew that it was pretty.
So is it extra doubly special to know that that was a song that did it for a lot of Bush fans?
Right, yeah. That was just a shock. I mean, we were not even sure if we were going to have it on the record.
We never did it live, did we, for years? You know, when we used to play in the clubs in London, it was like, you know, it was never really the right kind of song. You know, when you're in, like, playing to 200 people in a little club, it's like, all they want to do is leap up and down, and Glycerin would have been a real curveball. Get start playing this sort of, like, love song, you know, and the band sort of wanders off stage, and so we never did it for ages. So I suppose it was never in the forefront of our minds when 16 Stone was kind of formulating itself, gigs and stuff, and then just kind of, you know, he recorded it, you know, when we were in the studio. So it's like, yeah, it was like, Christ, this is good.
You reach this level now with 16 Stone. You have a new one coming out. There's going to be expectations on yourselves, fans, the industry, your label. Can you feel the anticipation? Can you feel the pressure at all?
Yeah, I think it just went to number one on the radio there today, actually. Yeah.
Swallowed it?
Yeah, on the radio charts, I think, yeah, the list, yeah, something like that, which is cool. I mean, it was like, they do the charts on Mondays, but anyway, so that means that's all going pretty good. There was, you know, you got to be crazy if you think there wasn't any pressure on our first record, because, of course, there's pressure on our first record. You know, that was the record that and make a record that you believe in, it takes, like, unbelievable pressure. This one had the same amount of pressure, which is maximum pressure. You know, you couldn't really have had more pressure, but that's just a personal thing. It's not for seeking to get a record deal or a record sale thing. You know, it's to make the right record and to represent yourself how you want to be represented for that time. And if you figure that we have, like, I don't know, 5.5, a lot of millions of people that like us or have bought our record, how could you possibly start to think about what it was about the record that each one of them might have liked or something?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
You'd pull yourself apart, wouldn't you?
you'd be dead, you know? You'd be like, it'd be gone. So it's just having to do what you believe in.
I came across a quote, and I think Nigel may have said it. It was in February 95, so a year and a half ago. And he said that every day is exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Do you still feel that way? Does the band still feel that way?
Yeah, of course it is. You know, every day still, I mean, we still haven't been to loads of places yet. You know, we still haven't, you know, we've done one show in Australia so far. So, it's just, what else would you want to be doing, really? I mean, I can't think of anything more fun than doing shows and being in a band.
I mean, you can't really complain that much. It's pretty hard, and you don't feel that good sometimes, because that's the way life is, but what a way to perk it, you know?
Yeah.
This is, you know, so we're really lucky. Everything is going really good, and work is, like, full on, and it's really fulfilling, and it's fun to be in a band touring, and I'm like, it's my birthday, and I'm on Bronte Beach, it's cool.